Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an IC693ALG221. This is an analog input card. It has four channels and it measures current from 4 to 20 milliamps. I have it in an IC693CHS397 5 slot rack. It's being powered by an IC693PWR330 power supply. And the processor I'm using is an IC693CPU374+. On the Proficy Machine Edition side, I've selected a new open file, and I have in my main rack the same 5-slot rack, PWR330, CPU374+, and ALG221 card as you see here physically. And I have it in run mode right now. It's all been downloaded and ran. The only thing is that I wanted to point out in the Proficy Machine Edition is if you right-click on slot number 2 or double-click on slot number 2, where the ALG221 resides, there's a subcategory tab called Settings. And in there, underneath Parameters, is a reference address, which, since this is a new file, the computer's automatically picked %AI0001, which is the address at analog input. Okay, so that tells me where I'm going to be able to see the readings that the device is going to be giving me. So what I want to do now is go to my default tables underneath reference view tables and select the top selection is %AI or analog input table. You can double click on that or right click and open. And then you'll have your reference table so that you can see the readings that the card is giving you. So we're going to go ahead with the test. Everything is in run mode. And if I open the door, the door wiring information is on the inside and it tells me what terminals go to what channel. So terminals 3, which is positive, 5 is negative, goes to channel 1. Terminal 4 is positive, terminal 6 is negative for channel number 2. 13 is positive and 15 is negative for channel 3. And 14 is positive, 16 is negative for channel 4. And what I have in the background that you can't see is a 4 to 20 milliamp generator that I have two probes, positive and negative probes, that I'm going to use to probe each of these channels to test the values. And what I've done is I've selected a value somewhere in the middle of 4 to 20 milliamps on the generator and not change it so that I can test each channel with the same amount of voltage to make sure that they all give me the same exact reading. I don't want a reading that is far beyond or below the reading that the previous channel has given me. Okay, so I'm on the last one right now. And all these channels give me the exact same figure, which is good. They all work. The OK light is on. So those are the things that I look for, really, is number one, if you think that there's a problem with the analog card, the first thing that you want to obviously check is that the OK light is on. There are some instances where the light has been bent and it's not showing through the hole here, through the window. That's usually not the case, but it has happened. So first check to see if the OK light is on, then check to see that all the channels are giving you the exact same reading. If you still think that there's a problem on one of the channels, you can go up and down with the reading, maybe bring it closer to 4 and then dial it up to 20 milliamps to see that you have the proper range that the device is supposed to be able to give you. Occasionally, when one of these cards are bad, it'll give you a reading, but it'll automatically give you the full reading of 32,000. So, in other words, you would put the probe on at any type of milliamp value, and it would give you full value. So it's an erroneous reading. This is a typical problem with analog current modules, and it's something that we do repair here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same-day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.